Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's an honor to be here, standing on this stage in this Asia or international open source event. Act like I know something. Thank you for the committee who that organized this event very well. Yes, we can applause for the committee. Thank you for the committee who successfully invited the sponsor to this event. The sponsor is important. The sponsor very kind to me, very kind to us. The sponsor pay for my car gasoline so I can ride it from Bogor to Surakarta. The sponsor is very kind, they are very kind. They pay for my hotel room. They are very kind, they provide lunch and snack for me. How about you? What do you feel about this event? You guys pay around $4 to $10 for ticket to this event, right? Some of you pay higher until $35. What do you feel contribute to this event? Do you feel confident? Do you feel great? I assume, yeah. You feel like I'm the contributor of this event, of this LUCA, right? Contribution is important. The sponsor, very kind to me, it's not because I'm one of the important person in this event. It's more like because I'm poor. I'm so poor, so I only can use, I can only use the pre-ChatGPT version 3.5 that I think currently is not intelligent anymore. I'm so poor, so I only have 5 Ubuntu Pro subscription for 5 machine only. I'm so poor, so whenever I download the LibreOffice on its website, I always skip the donation part. Always. Please. Just give me the software. No, thank you. I'm so poor. I want to do the donation. But you guys, you are rich. You afford to buy a ticket for this event. So please, stay rich. And next time you download the newest LibreOffice on its website, please, don't be like me. Do the donation. $5 would be good. $35 would be nice. Would be great. Yeah. Why? Because your donation, because your contribution, it is matter. Probably the security of the software is depend on your donation. is depend on your contribution. That's why contribution in open source software is important. So now let's go to the slide. In the beginning, as open source software enthusiast, the title that I put in my LinkedIn profile, which actually I contribute nothing to the open source software, but I love open source software. I love open source software, but I contribute nothing. I think I have believed that open source software is secure. Yeah, I feel confident about that. Open source software, it's secure. Some of you, I think, have similar opinion with me, right? Open source, because I love open source software. Open source software is secure. And then, this is heaven. It's around like 2 years ago. There's a global affected from Log4j vulnerability. It's affecting many industry because lot of industry using this software, and it's open source software. Log4j is for logging. It's open source software. Why this is happening? This has changed my mind. Open source software is secure, but this, why this can happen? The effect of the vulnerability can impact many industry globally. You name it. Any industry right now is using open source software. At least they put the open source software component in their business software. I can make sure that every company have open source software component in their business software. You name it, any industry is using open source software. Institution like university, we can ensure that they using open source software. Financial institution, they using open source software. Any institution, you name it. So why open source software become vulnerable? Because the project has been thankless. It's like, yeah, because we don't care about it. We only use it. We won't contribute to them. Yeah, that's what happening. Until right now, you can imagine that the open source software component is used by any organization, any business, including us, but we don't care, we don't contribute back to them. That's what happened. That's why open source software become not secure software. Oops. Then I try to change my mind, and if open source software is not secure, I think proprietary software is secure, right? Because open source, we can see the source code, everyone can see the source code, and it's free. It's free. I can get the LibreOffice without donate. So I think proprietary software is secure. And then this happened. One of the national state bank in Indonesia, all the service is done, all its service is done almost 1 week. And then we heard from the news that all the system is attacked by ransomware. And we know that from the news that the ransomware exploit services from Windows operating system. So it changed my mind again. Proprietary software is not secure. So all software can be not secure. And then I try to list other common opinions about security. The next opinion, security to obscurity. That means if we hide the source code, it will make the difficult for the attacker to exploit the software. But it can be wrong, right? And then if we spawn more vulnerabilities, it means the software is more or less secure. Is it true or not? I don't know. The more security attack number reported, the more or less secure the software. Yeah, we some of us have opinion like that. Open source can mean faster security fix. Yeah, I have that belief at the beginning. But you see, there's a case like log4j issue. Open source is unregulated because it developed by community, it came from anywhere. Is it true? It's unregulated. Yeah, I can give answer, but I think you need to find the answer as well by yourself. So you can, so you know, and you can choose that this opinion is right or wrong, right? So how to secure the open source software? To securing the open source software, it's generally I separate two phases. The first phase is in development phase, and the second one is in operation phase. If you guys come from DevOps, you probably understand, right? The development step and then the operation stage. So both of these stage I have to secure. Yeah. Every step on this stage, you have to make sure that the security is implemented on them. This is I get from one report on the internet. We can see that the many aspects need to be secured, and then the column show that which standard that can be a reference for us to secure the software or the security aspect. So how about security implementation in Ubuntu, Ubuntu development? Ubuntu claim that their distribution is secure out of the box by default and have available security features. Yeah, we can see that on their website, on the Ubuntu website, and then there's a lot of security features there. And I think we are who using Ubuntu already implemented in our environment. And then if we need to comply with the standard, Ubuntu also provide the technical aspect for the for us, for user, to comply to the standard or regulation. I list the some of the standard, PCIS, and then STIG, and CC. So yeah, Ubuntu developed already implemented the security aspect. Their developer already implemented the security aspect. And then for the maintenance, security maintenance, they have until 10 years. 10 years security update that user can use. They already provide that for the long-term LTS edition, right? LTS version. That's Ubuntu. How about LibreOffice? LibreOffice also provides security patch. They put it on their website. They put the update as well. So if there's a security vulnerability in the LibreOffice, we can download the patch from the website. And then they also announce what is the vulnerability, how to fix it, on which spec it will fix. They put on their website. How about the maintenance, security maintenance? The LibreOffice provided as well. If you are a conservative user, you can use the still version of LibreOffice. But if you are a technology enthusiast, you can use the fresh version of LibreOffice. They have a regular update for the bug fix, including the security fix. Some business, some organization need a principal support to convince them that whenever security issue happen on their business operation, they need support. They can have support up to principal level. And for Ubuntu, they provide principal support in form of subscription. Ubuntu Pro it's a subscription for the principal support of Ubuntu. They have three type: self, infra, and full. The self one that I use for five machine, but of course for business we use infra or full support. And then for other technology that derived from Ubuntu, like Chef, Swift, OpenStack, and Metal as a service, it's also available for the principal support. How about LibreOffice? Yeah, LibreOffice provide the principal support as well. So organization who need the principal support from LibreOffice, they have they already list the company they can support the LibreOffice implementation in our business. So let me close this presentation with, let me share three quotes that I collect from the internet. First, it's an old but gold, yeah? Old but gold quote about open source software and security. First, it comes from Eric Raymond, and it's popular with name Linus Law. Eric say, given enough eyeball, all bugs are shallow. I believe this eyeball it come from a motivated person, motivated expert or professional person, and it could be from you, right? And then the second one, it come from Bruce Snail. He is a security expert. He say that security is a process, not a product. Ubuntu and LibreOffice has been implemented the security in their development process. So if we using Ubuntu and LibreOffice in operation state, then it's our part to maintain it, to secure it, provided by the Ubuntu or LibreOffice. And then the last quote, it's not related to the open source software or the security. I just love this quote. It's my favorite quote. It's come from Master Oogway. He's one of character from the Kung Fu Panda movie, the first Kung Fu Panda movie. It's about yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Master Oogway say, yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery, but today is a gift. That is why it's called the present. Thank you. Have a nice Sunday. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, thank you to Mr. Utian for the presentation, but please stay here for a second because we will have a question and answer session. So, from the presentation that has been shared by Mr. Utian, anyone here have a question? Okay.
Okay, thank you. Good morning. My name is Jaffa. I'm from Jakarta. So my question is related to like the usage of open source, maybe library or framework. As we know, since we use open source software, we know that of course big open source project like Ubuntu or maybe Fedora and others have big backing and then have many contributors, and we can assure that that kind of project will have like optimal maximum security and stuff. But we also know that there's so many library on the GitHub and then in other open source community that were unmaintained, and we always saw like there's this project that have a less commit like 3 years ago and then 10 years ago, and in fact in the companies there's so many companies that still use this kind of library and or this kind of project in their code base. I think this will have like a security concern over the company, because like if there's a security bug or something that didn't address it, it will have like a serious consequence. So company will probably like made their own library themselves, and then they use it internally and they don't open source it. So what do you think about this kind of approach, and what do you think that we should do as an maybe open source minded software engineer for addressing this problem? Thank you.
Ask your company to open the library.
Yeah.
That's my suggestion. First, ask your company to open the library. Second, ask your company to contribute back to the upstream project. If they want to do that, just don't work to that company. Just get out from that company. And make your own company who contribute to the open source software. I think that's my answer.
Okay, thank you.
Any other question? Please don't ask
how many
difficult question.
Okay, we still have time. Ada yang punya pertanyaan lagi?
Ada satu lagi yang mau tanya ya, mungkin.
Bisa.
Beliau ini security angkatan. Ya, cyber security consultant, expert ya. Gitu. Mau nanya cara hack Facebook biasanya gitu. Ada satu lagi, oh ya.
Oke.
Okay. Hello, my name is Hanif, and I want to ask about recently, some 3 or 4 years ago, there are some popular vulnerabilities like about supply chain tech that affects both proprietary software like Microsoft and also might be some package manager like Cargo in Rust. And I want to ask about whether in Ubuntu or in general practice, how to avoid the supply chain attack itself, since maybe it's quite hard to detect and it's somewhat still too late and the product is already delivered to the clients.
Again, you represent question for your company, right?
No, it's not about my company.
Yeah, that's the supply chain is a complex situation in open source software, but I think some distribution, I don't know, I have to check again for the Ubuntu and LibreOffice about the. I think for the LibreOffice, because they are the upstream project, they develop all the code from the scratch, right? So probably there are no supply chain issue there. But for Ubuntu, Ubuntu it's a distribution. They packaging software from others project. So I think Ubuntu probably have supply chain potentially have a supply chain security issue. But I think some of vendors already aware of about that, and then they also provide the tools to track the from which producer the library come, from which producer the package come, and then is there any vulnerability to that library. I think the tools is already available, but not much. But let's find together about that. I can give more answer right now.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Is that enough? Still have time? Atau udah? Udah habis. Okay. So. Udah habis ya? Okay. So maybe you can ask in another speaker ya, atau mungkin nanti bisa
di
langsung
luar,
tanya
di luar.
Ya, di luar ini.
Sesi ini gitu.
Betul. Jadi thank you for Mr. Utian.
Thank you.
So give applause for our speaker.